Okay, so we figured out what the reflective impedance looking into the base of a transistor is. How do I use this for my circuit analysis? So here we are with the AC equivalent circuit. This is the intermediate step where the transistor is considered to be a current source. And from this circuit, this is the circuit that we're going to use to find Z in, Z out, and AV, the overall voltage gain. So to find Z in, basically we're looking into the circuit at this point, and what we're going to do is we're going to look at all the resistances and reduce it down to a single equivalent resistance or an impedance. So here we've got one resistor here, RB1. Let's put some values on it. Let's make that maybe 100K. And here's RB2. Let's make that 33K. We'll say RE equals 10. And big RE equals 1K. So basically, if I look in here on the circuit, I would see these three resistances as parallel. So Z in would be equal to 100K, parallel to 33K, parallel to, but this resistance here, these two guys are in series, so together they're 1,010 ohms. So that would be 1,010 ohms, but when I move it across the imaginary beta line and I move it out over here to this side, so when I move it over here to this side of the base, it's seen as beta plus one times greater. So I would multiply that by beta plus one times RE plus RE. Which is, let's put a number on it, let's say 201 times 10 plus 1K, which comes out to 203K ohms. So the impedance looking into the total circuit is 100K parallel to 33K. Parallel to 203K, and I'll let you crunch the numbers to figure out what that value is.